January 2, 2016. 7 Indian commandos and 1 civilian was killed in a suicide attack by Pakistani militants in Pathankot Air Force Base, Punjab, India. 4 heavily armed militants dressed in Indian military uniform entered Pathankot Air Force Base illegally and started their attack. They 4 were killed by Indian armed forces. Later evidences proved that these militants belonged to organizations that were operating out of Pakistan. Again, on 18th September 2016, 4 militants dressed in Indian Army uniform entered Indian Army base in Uri near LOC line of control and killed nearly 19 soldiers who were sleeping. All the 4 were killed and India was able to smell out Pakistani hands in this operation. These 2 attacks sent shockwaves across the country. The national interests here in India was clear. Clearly against Pakistan. The world was watching India. India as a country didn't support terrorism and was always against terrorism from its initial years of independence. India has even advocated it through many international organizations like United Nations, European Union, etc. So for a country which batted against terrorism is becoming a victim of terrorism, it didn't sound good for India. So there was a dire need for India to retaliate, to show Pakistan who it was. The surgical strikes was the only answer. So highly trained professionals from India's external intelligence agencies like RAW, RAW, Intelligence Bureau was geared up for action. The 4th and 9th Parachute Regiment of the Northern Command was ready for action. They were trained heavily. Everything in and out of the surgical strike, the point of entry, exit strategies, everything was well prepared and soldiers were well trained. Trained. India's intelligence documents read out that there were terrorist launch pads across LOC. So the main aim was to take out those launch pads. So the civilians across the border was secretively evacuated, and on the intervening night of 28th and 29th September, our helicopters dropped our soldiers at the border. By around 12:30 AM, our soldiers started venturing into Pakistani territories. It was a dense forest and visibility was low even during daytimes. As it was nighttime, it was extremely difficult to locate nearby objects. Even then, our soldiers escaped the radars of Pakistani military and ventured in successfully. In order to escape the night vision cameras and night vision glasses of Pakistani military, our soldiers have painted themselves black and green so that to escape from those cameras. Now, after reaching a certain point, they divided themselves into groups and started moving towards their respective bases. After a short while, each team reached its respective launch pads and the attack started. Our soldiers blew out every launch pad through grenades and bombs, shoot out every terrorist through snipers and rifles, and made sure that no one was left behind. The terrorists who were not expecting this faced the wrath of Indian Army and were finding it difficult to escape. The terrorists had no other option but to die in the hands of Indian Army. Our well-trained soldiers took out each and every terrorist and they started evacuating during the early hours of 29th September to India. Now, the terrorists were already waiting on India's planned way back to India. So the Indian Army had other plans. They scaled up the mountains, took another route and came back to India. In this process, one of our soldiers stepped on an IED, improvised explosive device. He was wounded to some extent. But there was no casualty from our side. Everyone reached a point and came back to their bases in a helicopter. Except that one soldier who was injured, everyone was safe. It was a victory for India. The next morning, our Director General of Military Operations informed this event first to Pakistan. Only after that, it was informed to Indians. Some 60 to 70 terrorists lost their lives. Now, it was a stern warning from India that anyone who eyes our territory or wants our soldiers will have to pay for that very heavily. From that, India has not shied away to retaliate when it gets affected. The Pulwama attacks, corresponding Balakot airstrikes, the brave act of Air Commander Abhinandan Vardhaman stands for its scrutiny. Thank you.